All right, Sir Tulfo, first off, let me get your reaction to the appointment of Valenzuela First District Representative Rex Gatchalian to your former post as DSWD Secretary. Were you informed beforehand about it, and what do you make of this appointment?
Well, Congressman Rex, or Secretary Rex Gatchalian, is a good friend of ours. When he used to be the mayor, we can contact him anytime. His constituents would ask help from us, and then we called him, and help is there. So I believe the president made the right choice of putting appointing Congressman Gatchalian as the new DSWD secretary. I believe DSWD will be in good hands, and I believe that social services will always come on time, especially during calamities. I am sure he will be able to deliver, because I've known this guy, I've known him for quite some time now, Mike.
But was the reappointment to your old post really off the table, according to the president? I mean, we heard the president acknowledge you did well during your time, but did you have any conversation with him about why there was no reappointment?
Well, I was last week the president made an announcement that he's looking for another position for me within the within the cabinet, but that doesn't require any more the approval of the commission and appointments, meaning under the office of the president. But, you know, Mike, there's a lot of ways serving the government. There's a lot of ways serving this country, Mike, not only working in the cabinet or in a government position, but a lot of ways, Mike, like what you've been doing in broadcast. I mean, we can still serve the people. We can still serve the country through our, through public service, Mike.
And two of the issues, let me just go back to your commission appointment hearings. Two of the issues that were raised against you are your citizenship and libel conviction. You have explained that you renounced your U.S. citizenship prior to your appointment. But the libel conviction, though, do you think it should have been a factor in your appointment at all?
Well, it was already explained, and we already have a reply to that, and we have it. My lawyers have it already. I don't want to discuss it already here over the radio, over TV, but we have prepared our statement, and I don't believe I fall on that category about that moral turpitude, because it should only apply to people running for public office, whereas my case, I was appointed by the president. But kahit na ganon, Mike, I still leave it to the decision of the authorities, the CA, and the president. So I believe we have already, or we are ready to respond to that. And I believe masasagot namin yan, Mike, given a chance to kung matatanong again if I'll be asked about that moral turpitude issue.
And let me just ask you this. What about your love life? Because it was also brought up. Do you think it was fair that that issue was also brought up during your confirmation hearings?
Well, Mike, when we are young, we do some things that sometimes we don't usually think, all right? We make mistakes in our lives, in our life. So hindi naman po pwede, Mike, na dahil nagawa natin yan, we don't rectify it. I mean, and then I believe it's kind of personal, but it's okay, Mike. I mean, wala naman tayong itatago. We can't hide that. It's a mistake. It's a mistake, but you can rectify it. And as you grow older, you change that. I mean, and you correct that. So, yeah, it was a mistake in life. I mean, wala naman sigurong perfectong tao. Kahit yung nagtanong sa akin, it's not perfect. We make mistakes along the way in our lives. And the only thing is to rectify that. Is dapat mong pabayaan your children, and which I did. So they were all taken care of. Almost all of them already finished in college. I sent them to school. They have their own work, jobs, businesses. They have their own homes. So I've taken care of that. Kung talking about love life, di lang naman siguro ako, Mike, ang tao sa Pilipinas na who was a very colorful love life. Hindi lang naman ako, hindi lang naman ako na government official, and a lot more. But I'm not proud. I'm not ayoko ipagyabang yon. It was a mistake, yes. But I learned a lot in those mistakes, which I did rectify right away. So Sana next time yung mga questions na ganun, sir, na sa mga ikang appointees na dapat hindi na masyadong personal yun. But anyway, siguro, I believe, perfecto yung tao kaya he asked that question. But it's okay.
But what was it, do you think, that prompted some lawmakers to oppose your appointment? Because there were some talks about supposedly the distribution of aid or subsidies to local governments. Some have also pointed out your commentaries in your previous job as a journalist and commentator. So what do you think was it? What is the real reason behind all these?
I'm not really sure, Mike. I wish I knew, but behind closed doors, I was informed na this is the reason and that is the reason kasi ganito, kasi ganon. Ay, ayoko nang pahabain pa. I don't want to elaborate further na ando talaga reasons. But I know, I was informed by people na kaya ka na bypass, it's like this and like that. And I'll just keep it to myself. And the lawmakers, the members of the CA already know that. As a matter of fact, they apologized after I was bypassed. So I do understand. May understanding naman kami. So it is okay, Mike. It is okay. They can ask that question. They have the authority, their right to ask me those questions about the citizenship. I have already answered that. Citizenship is not the issue anymore here. Your moral turpitude also should not be an issue anymore because it's an appointment, not a political office. But even though there's some law, ikanga, that we found out that we had researched now, I think only like around 5 years. Kung if you get a conviction, after 5 years you get convicted, you're okay. So long as yung conviction mo walang nakalagay doon na perpetual disqualification from holding a public office. But anyway, Mike, past is past. So I'm just trying to move on with my life, serve my country to my own little way. I'm back with the in public service right now, with helping with the ACCAS party list front office, which is I am the chairman now of our public service program.
You did mention a while ago about the president talking about appointing you to another position which will not require a CA appointment or a CA confirmation. Has that conversation happened already? Did he offer you a particular job or have you intimated a particular post to your liking?
I don't want to push it, Mike. I don't want to give the president, pressure the president or the administration to give me another position. No, Mike, I'm not pushing for that. If it happens, ikanga, it's really there, then it's really there. Pero like I said, Mike, I'm enjoying what I'm doing right now, helping, seeing these people coming to our office in Quezon City, asking for help, medical assistance, burial, and all legal assistance. So I'm fine with what I'm doing right now. So whether I be appointed or not, it's up to the president. And I'm not pushing it. I'm not pressuring anybody. I'm just happy with what I'm doing right now, Mike.
All right. On that note, thank you so much for joining us this morning, former DSWD Secretary Erwin Tulfo.